Feeling my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. They tell me I'm too young to understand. They say I'm caught up in a dream. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open up my eyes. So that's fine by me. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I didn't know I was lost. So wake me up when it's all over. When I'm wiser and I'm older. All this time I was finding myself and I.
From Channel 8 Eyewitness News.
Good morning, I'm Dave Crevassier with some breaking news right now. Eyewitness News is on the scene of a pretty serious car crash. Police say the crash has tragically taken the life of a local teen and has seriously injured several others. An Eyewitness News crew happened to be in the area and arrived on the scene prior to emergency personnel to give us this unprecedented look at a tragic crash.
What happened? What happened?
Control Tom 6103 arriving. You want to check out this car over here? Hey man, what happened? You alright? Yeah, what happened? You don't remember? Okay. You have anyone else in the car? I don't see anyone in the back seat, just the front passenger here. Okay, you okay? All right. How much you had to drink tonight? Huh? You haven't drank anything? Okay, go ahead and step out of the car for me. Careful. Let's come over here for a second.
Thank you.
quick, okay? So the first time, I'm gonna have you follow my finger with your eyes only, not gonna move your head, okay? So you're just gonna be looking at the tip of my finger. Do you understand? All right. Don't move your head, just your eyes. So what's gonna happen is we're gonna do a couple tests to determine if you're impaired, okay?
Basically, you got someone in the blazer.
All right.
He's laying down on the ground. We need to stabilize him and get him out. We're gonna get a helicopter coming from there.
All right.
Beside this car here, we have a female on the passenger side. We're gonna go ahead and start our situation on this.
All right, and we'll get this drug. We'll assist over there.
All right.
We need the medic class, get back forward caller, CDM.
Dispatch Heavy Rescue 44. We're on scene of a two-vehicle motor vehicle accident. One vehicle on its side. We have four patients. At this time, I'm going to need a second transport unit and Mercy Air to respond.
I'm going to administer a set of tests to determine whether or not you are impaired. My evaluation will be based on how well you follow my instructions and whether or not the tests are performed exactly as I demonstrate them. Do you understand? Okay. So what we're going to do, we're going to have an imaginary line right here, okay? A straight imaginary line. To start off, you're going to put your left foot on our line, put your right foot in front, touching heel to toe, your arms are going to be down at your sides.
Dispatch, can I get an ETA on Mercer?
Again, you're going to take 9 heel to toe steps down the line, counting your steps out loud. Your arms are going to be down at your sides. You're going to be looking down at your feet as you count your steps, okay?
About any drinking involved in the vehicle?
Yeah, it appears that the driver of V1 was drinking.
Blowing to this end?
Air 1, GF traffic.
Blow.
Just if I need to know what's wrong with the vehicle. So
is this the broadcast? They don't have any further on it.
Yeah.
Let's just hold right here against the median. Okay.
Yeah, they might not have been hurt as badly, and the one passenger might not have been killed had they been wearing their seatbelts. They didn't stand a chance, especially it's an open-top vehicle. When I got tossed to their side, they were thrown out like rag dolls. Spread your feet apart for me. Farther.
He's 19 years old.
He didn't pass all my tests.
Have them pull the video now of the front.
Go ahead and sit down. There you go. Kick your other foot out. Cross your ankles. There you go, just like that.
He is 13.
Okay, so what's your first name?
Erica,
my name is Linda. This is Misty. Can you tell me what happened?
Okay, what do we have today?
We got two vehicles. We've got one that was going, this little Toyota Corolla, westbound. They get actually get in the path of this Chevy Blazer who was going eastbound. Ejecting the driver and partially ejecting the passenger. We believe this is the driver. We're not 100% sure because they don't
have
no seatbelts. So.
All right, we have a seat back here. Watch your head getting in. There you go.
A very tragic scene there. The injured teens were transported to UMC Trauma Center. Channel 8 Eyewitness News had a crew there when they arrived and updating us now on their conditions.
You have one fatal that was left at the scene. With this case, we do have positive spider webbing in the window with a deformity of the steering column noted from the patient's chest.
Howdy, howdy.
Hi there.
Nice. What
do you guys got?
1, 2, 3.
No allergies,
no history.
Okay. All right.
To our knowledge.
All right. Let's check ET2 placement, get breath sounds.
For us that work here, we're very passionate about it, simply for the reason that we know that the majority of these could be prevented. A small amount of prevention, and you don't die. You don't come in mangled. You don't come in with broken arms, broken legs, broken heads, crushed chests, abdominal injuries. We don't see that. If you take care of yourself, if you pay attention, driving is a full-time job.
Go ahead and get some fluid started.
All right, get some shears and you cut off these clothes.
Do you have breath sounds?
You've got breath sounds, a little bit diminished on the right side. I've got massive skull trauma up here.
Okay, verify ET2 placement, check end tidal. He's sinus tacked, getting Brady on the monitor now.
We got our fluids going in.
I have no pulse. There's no pulse. Initiate CPR. I need chest compressions. Give me some epinephrine. All right, continue. When he gets tired, you switch out. Get epi drawn up. Analyzing. Looks like he's going into V-fib.
V-fib.
Charge the paddles. Continue compressions. Charging. Charging. Watch out.
Okay, back away.
Back away. Clear.
Clear.
Shocking.
Shock.
Shock delivered. Okay. Continue compressions. Epinephrine. This is for real. This happens. And this is something that is an active problem we need to address in our young children. Okay. This is all pouring out here. I got nothing.
I have brain matter here.
See, no active contractions.
Nothing. I got nothing. The heart's all open here. Okay.
Nothing on ultrasound.
He's got a massive tear in his heart. I think he's. This is fetal care. Any objections?
Any other ideas, thoughts?
A massive tear in the heart.
Okay.
Okay, that's it. Time of death. 9:42.
Thank God I didn't reach Daniel then. I would have two yet.
Hello.
Hello.
You are.
Hi, Mom.
Mom, I'm Dr. Fraser with the trauma team. You are
sister-in-law.
The sister-in-law.
This is big brother.
Hi. What do you know so far?
I just left the school and the helicopter came.
Yeah. So your son, he suffered massive trauma from the accident. He had a bad injury to his head where some of the brain was exposed. He had massive injuries to his chest. They brought him in. He had very low vital signs. He was very unstable. We initiated CPR. His heart stopped. And then we continued on, and we actually had to open his chest to see if we can stop the bleeding, and he had a massive injury to his heart, and he was not able to recover from that, so he died. I'm very sorry. I'm very sorry. We did everything we could. He just had catastrophic injuries that were not able to be repaired. I'm sorry. I know. But we were not able to resuscitate him. He had massive chest trauma and a hole in his heart there. We can bring you back if you want to see him, but I'm sorry for your loss. I'm very sorry.
Certainly a parent's worst nightmare and another young life taken as a result of this horrible crash. As you saw, police arrested one of the teen drivers for DWI. Channel 8 Eyewitness News is at the Clark County Detention Center for that part of the story.
Open. What's your name, sir?
I'm sorry?
Ricardo.
Ricardo, step over here. Do you have any knife or weapons on you? Anything sharp in your pocket? Anything might stick me?
No.
Okay. Any necklaces? Any jewelry on you? Any belly piercings? Necklace? Okay. Lean forward a little bit. Hand across the chest. Let me have your right hand. Have your left hand. Let's go this way. We're going to go see the nurse.
We're over here. Remain standing.
Do you have any allergies?
So what happened in the accident? You don't remember? Did you pass out?
In the first round. Just wait for an officer to call you up.
Come go with me. You want to take some fingerprints? Step over. We're gonna take some blood from you, okay? Which arm would you like?
This one. Right. Oh, you got it out. Come on.
Watch your hands. Roll up your arm. There you go. Perfect.
Quick poke. 1, 2, 3.
Stand up, please. All right. This way.
Thank you very much.
Okay, sir, look up at the camera. Look straight ahead. All right, sir, come go with me. All right, sir, step in. Okay, have a seat on the phone.
Good morning. This is case number 14M01234X, State of Nevada versus Ricardo Ledesma. This is the time scheduled for sentencing. State, are you ready to proceed?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And you're ready to proceed?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. State argument?
Your Honor, today the state's going to be asking you for the maximum of an 8 to 20, and it's unfortunate that I'm unable to stand before Your Honor and ask for more, which is what I would be doing, because this individual gave two children a life sentence. He killed a 17-year-old and an 18-year-old and seriously injured a third, Judge. I think if there ever was an occasion to impose the maximum, it's absolutely due in this case, given this individual's lack of regard for other human beings and the fact that those families will never have their children back again. That's all.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Scott.
Your Honor, Mr. Ledesma is, he's very young. He's 18 years old. Just barely turned 18, so he's just barely an adult. He pled guilty and accepted responsibility in this case, knowing that there are severe penalties for driving under the influence when it results in death or substantial bodily harm. And because he's accepted responsibility, he's asking for leniency from the court. He understands it was a mistake for him to get behind the wheel after having some alcoholic beverages. He's set to graduate from high school this June, and he's hoping to be able to do that, Your Honor. He knows that it won't be in the next couple of years because the minimum sentence on these counts is minimum of 2 years. So he's asking for that. That would be enough to teach him a lesson for what he's done. think the biggest punishment he's had so far is the guilt and remorse for losing some friends in this accident. They're both his age, and he actually knows them and knew them well. And so we're asking that he have a chance to be out of prison within the 2 years, and so we're going to ask for 2 to 5 years on each of those and run concurrent.
And Mr. Ledesma, do you have anything you'd like to say this morning?
I can't express how sorry I am to anyone, their families, or anything. I can't really even deal with the feeling that I lost my friends, and I can't believe I did it. That's all right.
Well, I appreciate the fact that you have remorse and that you've taken responsibility for what has happened here. Unfortunately, I see on too regular of a basis the devastation caused by somebody who makes the choice to drink and get behind the wheel of a car, and what happens when that choice is made. Your attorney refers to this as a mistake. Oftentimes I hear it referred to as an accident. It was no accident. It was no mistake. You intentionally drank, you intentionally drove, and you caused the deaths of 2 very young people and the absolute irreversible devastation to at least 3 families and hundreds of people as a result. Grandparents, parents, brothers, sisters, aunts, uncles, the community. I once had a friend who was in Metro Homicide for 20 years, and the last 2 years of his career he went to traffic. And I ran into him one day at a coffee shop, and I asked him how it was in traffic, assuming that it was much better than being in homicide every day. And he said it was so much worse because every single day he would go to a scene where a completely innocent person was where they were supposed to be, doing what they were supposed to be doing, and they were dead. And he said it was actually so much more emotionally trying than working in homicide for 20 years. Are your parents here?
Yes.
Look at your parents. Is that them sitting over there? Your family's completely broken. Your mother's heart is absolutely broken. And the families of Mr. LeMain and Miss McNeely, they'll never be the same. I once had a mother tell me that after the death of her child, she literally felt like she would die from a broken heart. And I can assure you that your mother feels exactly the same way. Unfortunately, I realize your remorse and I realize your regret. But based on the devastation in this situation, there is no place here for leniency. So I'm going to sentence you on each of the 3 counts to 8 to 20 years in the Nevada Department of Prisons. Those 3 counts will run consecutively. And that's my order. All right. Thank you.
All right.
Another young life ruined by making the bad decision to drink and drive. We go now to the Clark County Coroner's Office to find out more about the teen who was pronounced dead at the scene.
Examined tomorrow morning so we can document all of her injuries, because due to the fact that right now they believe the driver that struck them was under the influence, and so there will be prosecution. So we will be documenting all of her injuries of what occurred, and by tomorrow afternoon she will be able to go to a mortuary so that you can make any arrangements for her.
Is this your daughter, Shelby?
Yes.
Today, unfortunately, in a crash, a car came across the median and ran into the vehicle that she was riding in. She died instantly at the scene. The fire department and paramedics arrived. They were unable to find any vitals. I am so sorry.
So you can see just how many people are affected by this tragic crash. Driving while impaired is no accident, it is no mistake, it is a crime, and it kills people. Eyewitness News will have more updates on this horrible crash throughout the day.
Family that's lost a family member. We have friends that have lost their friend. We have boyfriends and girlfriends, they're gone. Brothers and sisters, they're gone. They're dead. Dead is dead. You don't come back. It's not a video game. And when you're dead, you're dead. And for us that work here, we're very passionate about it, simply for the reason that we know that the majority of these could be prevented. I don't think kids think anybody my age was ever their age. You know, and I understand that. I didn't think that when I was 16, 17, 18. I didn't think anybody was ever my age, okay? But we were, we all were. You know, I lucked out, I made it. And I want to see that they luck out. And it's not luck, it's planning. It's doing the right thing. It's not doing the wrong thing and getting behind that wheel. And that's a thousands of pounds of metal that's in there. It's a deadly weapon, and that's what people don't get. It's no different than a gun, and it demands the same respect as you would if you had a gun in your hand. When you're behind the wheel of that car, it's a deadly weapon, and if you don't do the right thing, you can die, your passengers can die, or you can cause someone else to die.